It looked good. It stands out. It's the best looking shop on the block.
A small business owner trying to revitalize his K Street storefront is instead forced to tear it down. This is a story you will only see here on KCRA 3. Mike DeSalle has been trying to get to the bottom of this all day, and he joins us now live at 9th and K Streets with the details.
Edie, it's well known that city leaders, they want to revitalize and breathe some life into a struggling stretch of K Street down here in Sacramento. But the store of this clothing store says what the city did today, well, that was the exact opposite. But the city says not so fast. Late this morning, the owners of Artifacts Clothing say the city forced them to tear down this wood facade that they say was meant to spruce up their K Street storefront. Some agreed.
It's attractive. It looks good. Tearing it down is ridiculous. Forcing them to tear it down is even more ridiculous.
So what happened? Why did the city force such a drastic change to this storefront? Especially since this wood facade has been up for 3 years.
This is definitely puts a damper on your spirit.
But the city says that Juan Carlos has only himself to blame. That's because 18 months ago, he asked the city for permission to put a sign up on this facade.
I believe that's when we kind of open it, kind of warms.
While considering a permit, the city realized this was a historic building and that neither the business owners nor Mo Mahana, the building's owner, ever got the proper permits to put this wood on the state-recognized historic building dating back to 1870.
It doesn't matter what the intention is. To me, would you put that on the entrance to Sutter's Fort? It's another listed historic structure. It just is not right.
Bottom line, the city says rules are rules, and without a special permit, this facade must be returned to its original facing.
Honestly, I think it's going to look horrendous. I think it's going to look ugly, and we just want the public to be a judge over that.
But again, back here live, the city stresses this is not about how this looks now. This is about the rules and regulations as far as historic preservation of buildings goes, plain and simple. Galston, Edie.
Well, we saw them ripping off all that wood. What's going to happen at the facade at this point?
Well, that's another kind of controversial aspect to all of this. While they said the wood had to go, the city's made a compromise. They're going to allow them to paint this facade now black so that it matches this black tile, which is over here to the right on the next building or the next storefront over. So while the rules are very hardline here for the city to say no wood, apparently there's room for compromise when it comes to the color of the paint. Live along K Street, Mike DeSalle, KCRA 3 reports.
All right, Mike, thank you.